okay? But I have some kind of things that I want to talk to you about. Because I consider Pickard Auditorium like my life, my home. Sometimes they've made fun and said, maybe I should set up a bed backstage here. I'm one of the drama directors here at Neenah High School. My name is Ms. Schneider, and I teach at sixth grade choir at Horace Mann, and choir and general music at the high school, and am the drama director for the middle school and high school. And I'm so glad you're here, but before we start, because it's kind of like my home, I have a few requests. So if you walked into my house, I would probably do the same thing. For instance, I would say, hey, can you kind of stay seated? We're gonna be having fun, but I need you to stay down. Two reasons. One, the chairs make an awful lot of noise for some reason, and it's hard to get reseated in them once you're out. Two is, the people behind you might not be able to see them, and that would be a bummer. The second thing is to keep your feet down. In fact, we have this policy in Pickard Auditorium that if you're a high schooler and one of the staff, like myself, sees you with your feet on the chairs ahead of you, you have to stay over and clean every chair in that aisle. For real, seriously. And I am like the best nabber of them all. I can spot a foot up anywhere. So, but we don't want them to be dirty, and we really value it here. And it's just something good to do when you go to an auditorium, because I know a lot of you, you don't have a lot of reasons to go to auditoriums, and so we just want to give you some hints on it. The other thing is, absolutely no food or drink. Why do you think we don't want to have that? Dude. Oh yeah, that spilling thing is a disaster. I have to tell you, I was at a show one day, and I was kind of where you were, and there was a dude way back there, and he had a can of pop. And it was open, and he put it down by his feet, and he got excited, and he didn't even think about it, and he kicked it. Now just imagine what happened, because the auditorium slammed towards the front. And all of a sudden, I felt pop rolling around my very cool shoes. I was not happy. So, it makes a mess, it distracts others, and we don't want to do that. Does that make sense to you guys? And that's something like every time you go to an auditorium, these are really good things to remember. Why would don't talk be on the list? Ma'am. Oh yeah, I have to tell you, I was at a show on Saturday, and some dude down the row was having a conversation about what they just bought at the store before they came. And I was like, hey, I really want to see this show. What are you doing? I don't want to know your grocery list, you know? So you might think it's kind of cool. Oh yeah, you know, but it distracts the people around you. And as one who's been up on the stage a lot, there's sometimes that I hear people talking, and we can hear you up here. I hear people talking and I want to say, talk a little louder. I want to know what you're talking about. Well, you don't want the performers to do that to you. Okay, so we're just kind of chilling back. Applause. And this is a weird thing, because when I started teaching many years ago, we never had this issue. People would come into an auditorium and they would know how to clap appropriately. I was at an orchestra concert a few years ago, and I'm not kidding you, this happened. It was a high school orchestra concert. And the people in front of me had brought a sign, just like you would to a basketball game. And when the song was done, they were like, yeah, way to go! Okay. Do you think that's good to do in an auditorium? Nah. So, I would like us to practice. Let's do as if we were at a football game. I'm not going to tell you which football game I would go to, because I might get run out of here. But a good professional football team, and we're there, and they just made a touchdown. What would you do?
Yeah.
job. That would support your team, and that would say, hey, you did a good job. Fantastic. However, in an auditorium, we want to be proper and a little more sophisticated. So no whoop, 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 okay? No signs. Go, okay? And we want to applaud. Now, oh. You guys rock, you are awesome. And I did want to say, you know, we always applaud when someone's done. Even if we think that they didn't do so good, okay? Why would you want to applaud no matter what? Ma'am in the red shirt. Hey, they tried. You gotta acknowledge that, right? They had the nerve to stand up here and look at all of you guys, which is a little scary, and perform. So you say, you know, that is cool. I'm glad you tried, okay? No matter what. Let's try it again. Here we go. Know if this is for the third through fifth graders or maybe the adults in the audience. This is one of my biggest pet peeves. My daughter's name is?
Sarah.
You got it made. And I love that I can tell when she's calling me no matter what, because she put her own ringtone on my phone, right? I know that. However, when I'm at a show and I'm sitting back and I've got my phone on and that goes off, what happens? Yes, sir. Oh my gosh, I was at a musical on Tuesday night where the guy's thing was like a hip hop. And after the third time that it went off, someone on stage said, could you either answer that phone or stop it? You know, because it's annoying. My other problem is, so Sarah calls me, I don't answer it, it's annoying, it's done. But she always leaves me a phone message then, and then you would hear this. Oh no, that's not what you would hear. Hello. This is why my daughter does these for me, because I'm not so good at it. Okay, so this, see now, and I set a new one then. That is a bummer. This is what goes off when someone leaves me a text message. Now, how am I gonna feel when they're playing and that goes off in my pocket? Sir, oh my gosh, like crawl into the seat as much as I can. So, you got the auditorium rules? So, I'm gonna go away and then we're gonna start in a second, okay? Here we go. You know what I just did? I silenced my phone. Excellent idea for everyone. Well, I want to welcome you to Neenah High School. My name is Miss Carol Schneider, and I am so glad to be your MC tonight. And tonight, it's been a long day. Today, we want to talk about beat. And beat is defined as the basic unit of time or pulse. The best way to feel the beat is with a march. Mr. Dunning, who's hiding out someplace, is the director of the Wind Symphony. They will be playing a march, a piece of music that is very easy to step to and keep the beat. The band will actually be playing a circus march that helps you imagine the clowns at the circus. Can music really do that? Huh. You can hear the clown's dogs barking and even the sound of a clown being shot out of a cannon. I can't wait. Our student conductor, which by the way, was from Hoover, is Ashlyn Schwer and the Clown Act. About beat. They get confused about the difference between beat and rhythm. Simply, rhythm is the long and short patterns that work with the beat. I'd like you to try something with me. You guys all know row, row, row your boat, right? Okay, so on your leg, we're going to tap the beat. We'll start together, you ready? Here we go. Row, row, row your boat, gently down the stream. Why am I the only one? Merrily, 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 my. Let's do it again. Row. Now we're going to do it, and instead of tapping the beat, we're going to tap the rhythm. The difference is the rhythm is that short and long that we use. Let's do that together. We have to start together, guys. Okay, here we go. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 high. A tree. Let's do it again. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Did you notice that I almost caught myself making a mistake? Because when we were at Dream, it's a long note, and I wanted to put a beat in there. So sometimes they're very hard to tell the difference. In elementary world, we count rhythms with tas and tutis, right? No? Oh, okay, just checking. So we might go ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Will you do that with me? Here we go. Ta, ta, ti, ti, again. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. That is fantastic. You might do it with the quaver hand cymbals. Do you guys do those? Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. Will you do that with me? Here we go. Ta, ta, ti, ti. Again. Ta, ta, ti, ti, ta. You guys rock. Okay, give yourselves a hand. Nice auditorium applauding. I'd like you to come and teach our audiences that some night. And in middle school and high school, we count rhythm with numbers. So instead of saying ta, ta, ti, ti, ta, I would say one, two, three, and four. Will you do that with me? Here we go. One, two, three, and four. Excellent. The concert choir looks ready now. They are led by Miss Westcott, and they are going to share a piece that only uses rhythm counting. Enjoy, count on it.
And one and two and three and four 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 and one and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four
and a one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four and a one and a two and a three and a four and a one.
Is one of the four different choirs we have at Neenah High School. Beat is so important to keep a large group together, but it also helps keep one performer stay steady through the whole piece. Our next performance shows us how important it is for everyone, large group, one, or maybe even just three, to keep a steady beat. Welcome Emily, Natalie, and Patrick at the piano. Coolidge. Way to go. Thank you. neat? It was so neat how they passed the music on to Patrick, who didn't even get a seat, because he had to play the whole piano. It's just, if just one of them had made the beat go faster or slower, it would have been a disaster. And I'm so glad it wasn't. Next up is the orchestra, led by Mrs. Stingle. I'm sure the orchestra is up next. And they have some great examples of how important beat is. But let's try some ourselves, okay? So, you've got tapping on your leg, right? So should we start out fast or slow? Did I even have to ask? Okay, so go with me, okay? Here we go. Beat, 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 beat. Okay, my leg's getting tired. Can we slow it down? Slow down, slow. How slow can we go? Oh, you guys rock. And let's speed it up again. Here we go. Do you see how important it was that they worked together? Can you imagine how long it took for them to practice? Because they could practice by themselves, right? But how do you think Patrick's part would have sounded if he was the only one playing? Yes, ma'am. Yeah, almost like a... Hard to practice, right? So it's important that we stay together as a group. And that would be fantastic. Hey, since we're doing Row, Row, Row Your Boat, can I set a tempo? What does tempo mean? Yes, sir. Excellent. It's just like when you're in a car and you decide, well, hopefully your parents make wise decisions, but they decide how fast or slow we're going. Same thing with the beat. We can decide that. So let me start out with this. This is a good tempo for me. Will you guys start that? Let's sing together. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Okay, I have to tell you, that's a snoozer for me. It was too slow, wasn't it? So I need to change the beat. And so I'm gonna change the beat. You guys take my tempo, okay? Are you ready? Are you watching? You ready? Here we go. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merry, 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 merry life is again. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merry, 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 merry life. Excellent, but I have to tell you, that wasn't my favorite either. I kind of like something in between. How about you guys? Can you give me an in between? Here we go. Row, 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 row. Once more. Row. You absolutely rock. So now I would like to say, next up is the orchestra led. What? One more? Yeah, we can do one more. In fact, this is the challenge, Mrs. Stingle. We're going to do, we were tapping the beat, right? We're gonna tap the rhythm. Remember, I made a mistake last time when I did it. Can you see if you can do it without a mistake? I'll try harder. Here we go. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, merrily. What a great job. Do it again. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 merrily. Life is but a dream. Okay, so while orchestra is getting set up. They've got all different kinds of new instruments that they're going to introduce to you. Looks a lot different than what we've seen before. But I would like you to raise your hand if you are playing a band instrument, like what we started with. Way up high. Way to go. So put your hands down and raise your hand if you're playing a string instrument. Excellent. I love seeing all of you out there. I like to play a band instrument. I'm a French horn player. That's part of the brass group. But I like playing an orchestra instrument too. I'm a string bass player. But my favorite of all is singing. Do any of you like to sing? Yeah, way to go. Mrs. Stingle? She's gonna talk to us about some great examples of how important it is.
Good morning, everyone. The orchestra students are so excited to play for you today. So the string orchestra is made up of the violins, the violas, the cellos, which are a little blocked by the piano right now, and the basses. And we're gonna play two pieces for you today. The first is called the Ashokan Farewell, and it's a waltz, which is a dance, right? So we're gonna play a dance tune. It has three beats in the measure. So it would go one, two, three, one, two, three. Do you feel that beat? Three, one. Yes, I like that some of you are conducting with me. Not clapping, but conducting. Wonderful. Okay, stop. Great. So, when the orchestra plays together with the same beat, it can be very, very beautiful. But what happens when we don't play with the same beat? What happens? Let's find out. Okay, so what happened? Right down here, what's your name?
Miriam. It didn't sound that good.
Didn't sound that good. How many agree with Miriam? It didn't sound very good. Okay. Well, orchestra students, we gotta do better than that. Okay. So, we're gonna try this again. But this time, all the students on stage, they're gonna play using the same beat and the same tempo, which is how fast or slow it goes, right? We're gonna hear what a difference that makes.
Thank you.
Is that better that way?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So our next piece is called I Will Wait by the popular group Mumford & Sons. And one of our orchestra, Belle Gallegos, and she's walking, she's on her way, she wrote the parts out for this piece so our orchestra could play the song for you today. So we're going to need some audience participation for this piece. And listen to what I'm asking you for before you volunteer. We want you to keep the beat with us today, and I know that you've been doing that already, which is fantastic. We need a few brave students to come up on stage, wait for it, to play along with us in the percussion section. Okay, students, do you all have muffins? Okay, great. So a few students from the orchestra are gonna come out and they're gonna select some volunteers from the audience. Now is your chance. Now is the time to raise your hand. Who would like to join us up on stage? I know I wish we could bring you all up. High school students, we have some volunteers. They're gonna come on up, and we may have some adults in the audience that would be willing to join us as well on an instrument or percussion. Some adults, just come right on up. Okay, it looks like our selection is done, so you go ahead and put your hands down. I'm so sorry. But I'm so happy to see so many wonderful students willing to volunteer. That's fantastic. Okay, so how are we doing with getting our percussion all set up? Okay, we have enough room. Okay, now students, we're gonna give you some directions up here in a minute. And maybe you see some more familiar adult faces up here as well. Anybody see their teacher or someone that works with them during the day? Are you surprised to see them up here? Yeah, it's awesome, isn't it? Okay, so we're gonna do a little demo here. On the lower strings, so the cellos and basses, along with our percussionist over here, we're gonna play the beat, and I want you to tap your foot along and keep the beat with them, okay, bud? And pause your foot, pausing all feet. Thank you, okay, we're gonna set the tempo. We're gonna do this for about 20 seconds. Our percussionist is gonna set our tempo, and then we're gonna start tapping and playing along. Are you guys ready? All right, here we go, one, two, percussion, go. One, two, three, four, two, two. Tap and play. We're gonna do the song now. We're gonna play. We have our student volunteers. We have our staff members. Are we ready, orchestra? All right. So we're gonna have the percussionist play until verse 3. Okay, well, you're gonna stop playing for a little while so you can watch the students. They're gonna stop playing. The high school students are gonna stop playing for a little while. When they stop, you stop. When they go, you go. Okay, we'll cue you. And the very last note, we're gonna hold. So you're gonna shake or tremolo or shuffle, okay? And Belle is going to be amping. We have some soloists up here, which you may or may not be able to see. They're gonna be playing the vocal parts on their instruments. So good luck to everybody. Here we go. Thank you. job, volunteers. Let's give our volunteers a round of applause.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Stingle, and all the volunteers who are willing to come on up here. Way to go. Beat is so important for a little four-letter word that it has many words related to it, like tempo. Now, this dude here told me that tempo is the fast and slow, and we worked a little bit with that. It has meter, which gives us a different feeling. It has rhythm, of course, because we've already tried that, right? And it has something called groove. When you pay attention to different parts of the beat, you create a different feeling. So, now this one's a tricky one. We're gonna try it, okay? Are y'all with me? I know that a lot of your feet don't go down to the ground, but if they do, I want you to tap. If they don't, you know you can tap in the air. I tap in the air all the time, so I don't get in trouble for making noise, but tapping, okay? So everyone get tapping with me. Here we go. Don't speed up. You're rocking the world. Way to go. Keep it going. You could get a speeding ticket. Slow it down. There we go. Now I want you to clap on one and three. Here we go. One, two, three, four. 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 Get the feel. We got it. Thank you. You guys rock. Okay, you can stop. We're going to try a different way this time, though. Okay? We're going to try to give a little more importance to beat two and four. So let's get our beat going. Here we go. One, two, three. And let's snap on two and four. One, two, three, 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 four. Keep it going. Excellent job. Could you feel a difference? Well, that is what we call a backbeat or an offbeat. And it gives you a different feel, and that's the definition of groove. The jazz ensemble will be playing a traditional tune made famous by the renowned jazz trumpet player Louis Armstrong. It was written back in 1928. I know that seems like a long time ago, but it was even before my mother was born. So this piece has a very steady beat, but it is unlike almost anything else you have heard this morning. Mr. Dunny?
Good morning, everyone. Thank you. All right, so this is the jazz ensemble, and one of the things that we do in jazz is we tend to play things a little bit differently. I'm gonna have Martin back on the drum set. Everybody say hi, Martin.
Hi.
Martin, say hi, everyone. Okay, thanks. Would you give me... This is what you might hear from most of the music that we listen to. It will sound something like this, the beat will. Okay, we call that straight. In the jazz band, we call that straight. Okay, but in the jazz band, we will do what we call it swinging the beat. And swing sounds like this. And that incorporates what Mrs. Schneider was just doing with us. Do that again for me and keep going. Feel that backbeat? In jazz, we tend to emphasize that backbeat. Okay? All right, very good. Let's see if you can hear that backbeat as we play this piece for you. Again, this is a piece written by Louis Armstrong. And this is Armstrong High School. And I like to tell my friends that the school is named after Louis Armstrong, even though it wasn't. I know, I got some after back there. Thank you, adults. Appreciate that. But we're going to play a piece. This is called Strutting with Some Barbecue. And we're going to feature two of our soloists. And they're going to improvise in that backbeat, beat, feel, groove thing that you were just experimenting with. But you're going to hear from two people. You're going to hear from Patrick DePoto on the trombone. And Patrick is a graduate of Coolidge. Where are the Coolidge people? Woo! Okay, good. And then you're going to hear some tenor saxophone playing from Sophie Zillis. And Sophie Zillis is from Roosevelt Alliance. You got anybody? And I'll tell you a secret. I went to Roosevelt, too. Okay, here we go. This is called Strutting with Some Barbecue. Thank you.
Symphony and the Jazz Ensemble. I hope that today you got to do a few things. One is, hey, you got to come into our house, and I really appreciate that because I love seeing people. It does my heart well. But you got to learn about our different groups that we have here and how people can like different kinds of music and come through. And I hope that you learn that beat, no matter what kind of group you're with, if you're singing, if you're in orchestra, if you're band, your jazz band, that beat is all the same. And music is just universal to our world. So thank you very much for coming, and I greatly appreciate it. Have a great day. Let's hear it for these wonderful Neenah musicians, huh? Being a wonderful audience. Now, please give me your full attention. In a minute, I will call your school. Right now, I want you to stay in your seat. When I call your school, I will give you a specific door that you are going to exit, and that's where the buses for your school will be. When you leave your seat, you want to look around and double check that you have all items that you brought with you. Thanks for taking good care of Pickard, but also thanks for taking good care of you and your personal items. So, our first school to leave is going to be Tuller School. Are going to go out that door and out the front door. Follow your teachers that way.